There are four ways that you can earn money that can range from working 24/7 to doing basically nothing. And personally, I'd like to do basically nothing and make a lot of money. What's up guys, it's Avery here. If you're new to the channel, I'm all about personal finance, investing in real estate, and teaching you how you can build your wealth, as I've built my wealth over the past couple of years since I've finished school and have now bought a couple of properties as well as amassed my net worth to over $500,000. And I'm here to help you do the same. So if that sounds cool to you, make sure you stick around through the end of the video and I'll talk about the four ways that you can earn some money. So these four ways are gonna be split up into two and two, and the first two are going to be active income sources and the second two will be passive income. And that first one is known as being employed, which many of us are, and how many people will make their money. Often you work for a company or you work for someone else and you get a steady paycheck and you get benefits, and that's really just how you make your money. And as soon as you stop working, you no longer will be making any money. Making money as an employee is a very standard way that we are taught to do it. We are taught in school to do well in school so that we can get a good job, so that we can get that corporate position, so that we are able to have a steady paycheck, so that we can buy that house that is too expensive, that we don't actually like living in anyway, so that we can retire once we're older and then enjoy our life then. Once we've climbed up that corporate ladder and reached all of our goals and done all of those fulfilling spreadsheets throughout the day. And this is a very standard way that people earn money, and it is definitely the least risky way to earn money because you are working for someone else. You are not taking on any risk of the business. The only risk you're taking on is that you could get fired at any moment. So with this type of active income, you are employed, you are working on someone else's schedule, they are telling you what to do, and every amount of work that you put in and all of that effort is making someone else richer. But again, it is far less risky because if the company goes under, all that happens is you lose your job. You don't lose an entire company that you have built. So it's far less risky than if you are starting your own business or being the head of that business. But on the same coin, there's far less upside potential. Yes, you can work your way through the corporate ladder, but the only way to do that is if you put in a lot of effort, time, and beat out all of the competition of those around you. And it may be a draining process, and it may not actually seek out any rewards if you put in a lot of extra hours. Just because you're putting time in doesn't mean you'll get more money out of it. And this is one negative thing of just having an active job. And there's nothing wrong with having an active job. I personally have an active job and it is my primary source of income. And I think with that primary source of income, you should take it into earning money in the next three different ways that I'm gonna talk about, so that you can not necessarily just work for someone else, make them richer, but hopefully you can have other people work for you or have your money work for you and you get richer. The next active income piece would be those who are self-employed. And there's a very standard story when it comes with those who start their own business, become self-employed, and give themselves a job. And yes, I said give themselves a job and not necessarily start a business. There's a book known as the E-Myth or the Entrepreneurial Myth that talks about someone who is opening a pie shop because they absolutely love baking pies. Which sounds pretty cool. I'd enjoy smelling, eating, and doing all things related to baking all day, but maybe that might make me a little bit tired of it, especially when I also have to worry about the logistical side of the business, accounting, suppliers, selling the pies, and all of those things. And that's exactly what happens with this person who starts their pie shop. Not only have they given themselves a job to make pies, which at the time that they started really enjoyed, but they also gave them every single job associated with owning a business, which made them hate making pies in the long run. So if you're gonna start your own business and give yourself a job, note that you are most likely going to be working a lot more than you would if you were just an employee, but you have to make sure that you can start delegating some of that work. And if you're self-employed, not only do you have to work a whole lot harder because you're taking on a lot more risk as well as a lot more work, but you pay a lot more in taxes. When you're working at that corporate company, you had your tax rate, but now that you're self-employed, there's also a 15% added self-employment tax, as well as the fact that you now have to pay full-on for health insurance. Personally, every 2 weeks or every time I get a paycheck, I pay about $52 for the worst possible health insurance plan that I have, and my company pays about $500, which is just crazy the amount of health insurance costs, but not what this video is about. So when you're self-employed, all of that extra work that you're putting in ends up going towards tax as well as other costs that you didn't have when you were an employee. And really with the self-employed portion of earning income, you haven't really started a business. You've just given yourself a job that you might end up hating. So if you're gonna start a business, let's take that towards step number three, starting a business instead of just being self-employed. So this third way of making money would be having a business. And this is a far more passive way of making money. And again, you can be as active or as passive as you want when you have that business. If the part of the business that you really like is making pies, maybe that you could make a couple of pies every now and then, but also hire other people to make pies so it doesn't feel like such a burden and you're just doing it when you enjoy it. Or maybe you can start a completely different business so that it runs on its own, and then at home, you can make pies when you wish to, which is probably the best way to do it because it's more likely a hobby to you and something that would be very stressful to start as a self-employed job. So that's great when you can start this business because you can hire other people to do those tasks and they will cost less than the amount of profit that hopefully you can take in for your business. And this is a far less active way to make money. Now, obviously, it's going to be a lot of upfront work. You're going to have to learn about hiring and making sure you're bringing the right people on your team. But once you have that strategy and those systems in place, you're able to sit back, relax, and see how well that business is working for you instead of you working for that business. So now that we've gotten to the more passive side of the coin, the fourth and final way, which would be the best way that you can make money and the one that is the best for your finances, would be investing. Investing will be the most passive way that you can earn some income and the way that you can get your money to work for you. In the third one, talking about starting a business, we're getting your business to work for you and you still have a lot of costs like taxes, as well as paying your employees benefits and insurance and things like that, and corporate taxes and all of the like. But when it comes to investing, this is the best way for you to earn money as well as avoid a lot of taxes, build your wealth and have other people pay off debt and do great things for you while you're just hanging out and your money is working extremely hard. The most common way that people will earn money in investing is through their 401k plan, which goes along the lines of really the two ways that people earn money would be through being employed as well as just investing in that standard 401k plan. But we can take that a lot further and we can start investing in the stock market, in brokerage accounts, as well as through a Roth IRA or a traditional IRA, depending on how much money you are making. And that can start earning a lot more money for you instead of you just wasting that money and spending it on things that you don't really care about. And some great things about investing in the stock market or buying a rental property and real estate, or even buying other businesses that start working for you, is there's a lot of great tax benefits. So the thing about buying stocks is that you aren't taxed on them unless you sell them. And if you never sell them, you are never going to be taxed on them. Same thing with rental property. If you never sell that rental property, you aren't going to be taxed on it. Unless you can sell it and do a 1031 exchange, but that's for a different video. The next thing that I'm going to describe is how a majority of wealthy people in the world make sure that they pay little or zero taxes and still have an extremely high net worth that continues to grow and grow and grow without them having to do very much. And it's known as buy, borrow, die. So like I said, you go buy these stocks or you have these other assets like real estate, and then instead of making sure that they increase in value because you bought the right thing, and then selling them, and then you paying the government some of those profits that you worked really hard to get, you just borrow against those assets. So in rental property, I've talked about this before on my channel, but it's very easy to see. You could do a home equity line of credit where you could tap into your equity in your home and then go leverage that to purchase other things. Or you could do a cash out refinance where you refinance your home and then you get some money out of it at the time, and then your loan value will increase. But with stocks, you can do this as well, where you can take a loan against the amount of money that you have invested in your portfolio. And the key here is that with your stock portfolio, it increases at a higher rate than the interest rate on the loan that you got borrowed against your stocks. And this allows you to stay net positive, have that cash that isn't taxed, because debt isn't taxed. If someone gives you a loan and that money is now yours, you are not taxed for being in more debt. Same thing with the examples of the property that I talked about. If you take out a home equity line of credit or get a cash out refinance, you are not taxed for that, which is the most important part here, because you still have that asset growing and growing, and then you're able to take money against it and use it without it being taxed. And then the best part about this whole thing is when you die. So a little bit morbid to think about, but the best part of this is when you die. And I'm saying that while smiling because instead of you selling them to your kids before you die or handing them off to your heirs before you die, you put it in your will or in your estate planning, and then you give those assets to your kids. And because your kids are none the wiser and the government is for not taxing the wealthy, they make it so your kids don't pay any tax on those gains that weren't technically realized because you didn't sell, you just handed them over to someone else. So if you had a $100,000 stock portfolio and then over the course of your lifetime until you passed away, it turned into $5 million, you wouldn't pay $4.9 million of taxes. You would just give that to your kids and your kids would have a $5 million stock portfolio and they would start from scratch and it would continue growing for their entire lives and so on and so on and so on. With the four ways that you can earn some money, the first one is very standard for us and very active, but it's the easiest one to start and think about. And actually investing is probably the second easiest in my opinion to start, because just investing in the stock market is pretty simple. You can open up a brokerage account and start investing in low-cost index funds or ETFs, or you could buy a rental property like a house hack where you could buy a two-unit building, live in one unit and rent out the other, and then you could move out eventually and have that rental property. Those are two very easy things that you can do while you have that active job. And the hardest would be being self-employed because you're giving yourself so many jobs and it's still very active. And then also starting a business is quite difficult and making sure that it's successful and delegating roles to people. So I think number one and number four are really the best ways that you can earn some money. And I would like people to take their number one source of income, that earned income, and then put it into investments so that they can start growing those assets and not being taxed because they're borrowing against it and having that debt and then passing that wealth onto their kids. So let me know in the comments which type of ways you are earning money. If you have that active job, or if you've given yourself a business where you are every single person and do every single job within that business, if you've started your own, if you've sold one, or if you're purely an investor and just buying big amounts of real estate, it'd be cool for me to know to see the demographic of the audience. So thanks again for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that video and learned a little bit. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe if you enjoyed this. It would really help me out for that YouTube algorithm and get this video to more and more people. And if you like me here, go ahead, check me out on Instagram where I like making reels, as well as check me out on TikTok. I like doing the back and forth talking to myself conversation style where I'm teaching you guys more things about building your wealth there. Thanks again for watching, and more wealth is coming your way.